Hey there, this is Erica from Ever Educating, and this channel is all about teaching tips and ideas for new college instructors. Today's video is about a new edtech tool that I've added to my PDF that you can access below, and it's called WiseMapping, and it's a website that you can use for free to create concept maps or mind maps. And so this could be a great tool for your students to use in the classroom and also for homework. So in today's video, I'm going to go through all the main features so you can figure out if it's something you want to try yourself or with your students. WiseMapping.com is a free tool you can use to create concept maps or mind maps. You know, have your students do this. It's 100% free all time. So obviously Canva is another graphic creation tool that's an option. If you just look up mind map, you'll get a lot of templates. But of course, they're much busier than the one that I'm using with WiseMapping. Keep in mind that I will have a video coming up soon that's about how you can use Canva in the classroom and to teach if you're interested in that. Go ahead and subscribe so you remember to make sure to see it once it comes out. But okay, so WiseMapping, you can sign up for free or you can try it with no login. I'm going to just try it with no login because I tend to mind map on paper rather than digitally. So I'm going to show you the tool, but there's one big con to just trying it out without registering. And that's that you can't actually download what you create. So you'll see in a second that there's a lot of elements you can add to it that makes it more interactive. But if you just do it without the login, then you can create the mind map, and then what you could do is you can have the student screenshot it, and then they can give it to you. But it won't be interactive in the same way. If you don't care about that, then obviously they don't have to register. If you do, then they will have to register. So that's the one that comes with the template, so it's easy to kind of delete going forward rather than starting from scratch. But here's an example of one I've made. And so you can obviously use this tool in a lot of ways. So you can have students, you know, concept or mind map a paper outline, which is what I have here. It can be about terminology they've studied, a proposal that they have for research, whatever the case may be. And so here is an argument that this student, you know, will write about for Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone. And so I kind of just created it kind of going in this circle, right? So an intro paragraph, my two main points, a counterpoint, and then a conclusion. And then I have obviously little examples of each point here. So we're going to just go through the list and show you each of the elements. So over here is a save button. You can save as you work, though again, you cannot download it if you're not registered. If you make a mistake, you can easily click the undo button. So you can zoom out or zoom in as you'd like to make sure it's easy to read. And then if you notice here, these words are bigger than these, and that's because you can click, and then if you want to change the size of the text, you can do that very easily. So you can, for example, keep it large, and then just obviously change these to large well so they all match with one another. I'm not going to bother doing that here, but it is an option for you so that it's easier to see for the readers. Okay, so that's just one option. Same with if you click on the words, you can also change the font if you want to something else. But I like how it looks here. Now, after the plus and minus, zooming in, you can also change the topic shape. So here's a topic, right? And let's say I wanted to change it to a square, I can do that. Okay, if I wanted to change the topic color, I can go ahead and change it to white, so it's obviously easy to read. But I personally like the line more. Okay, after that, you can go ahead if you, let's say, click this one. And okay, rather than adding a topic, I want to delete it first. So I just want to get rid of this because I only needed 2 points. Very easy to do. Let me undo that. Or you can say I want to add a topic. So if you go here and you click add, now there's a new subtopic. And then what's easy is you can move it around however you'd like. So maybe it's tied to the main point. Maybe it's tied to the second point. Maybe it's tied to the third point. And so you can layer it very easily however you'd like. Okay, so I'm going to delete that. And then there it's gone. So that's adding a topic and deleting a topic. Now, if you want to change the color, so let's click in here. And we're going to change the color of that to a blue. And then click here as well and change the border color to a darker blue. So now it matches more with the style that you want. So these are to change the color of the topics, especially if you add a shape to them. Now next you'll see here, for example, and then there's another one here as well. There's little icons. So let's pick children here. Click the icons and then you're limited, but you know it has a good amount that you can add here. And so you might find that one matches well with whatever it is that the student has written. So I'll add the little boy there because I am talking about Harry Potter and children right there. Okay, so that's the icon issue element. Then notice here next to Adele, I have this little icon that's a note icon. And so you can add a note. So in this example, it's a quote that I would reference in my paper, right? They can have it type it out here, accept, right? And so that's the button that you do to add a note. So you just click, add note, type out the note, and accept. If you want to get rid of the note, click into it, and just remove it. Now, let's say you have a link to a source that you want to make sure to remember for a certain part of your argument or the concept map that you're creating. You can just click, add a link, and type it out here, and click accept. I have an example here. So if you click into it, and then open URL, it opens to that URL that you have, and you can also remove it if you don't want to have the URL included. So that's right here. Now, if you want to add a relationship outside of how it looks here, you can go ahead and click, let's say, intro, relationship, and here's an arrow. And so let's say maybe you want to connect it to this point. Now the arrow is right there. You click into it, and you can make it more curved. Okay. You made an error. Go ahead and click, and you can delete it. So you can add additional relationships to your concept map. Now, as I mentioned here, you can change the font type and the font size. You can also bold it or italicize it or change the color. So as you see here, I put this in red because the thesis is the most important part of this particular element of the paper. Okay, and so those are all the elements of this. You can also change the name of the map if you're registered to do so. So once I would finish, or the student would finish creating this, they would, in my case, I have a Mac, Command Shift 4, and they take a screenshot of what they've created. Of course, the screenshot, as I said, will not include any links or do anything along those lines. One more thing that I will say is if you, let's say, add a third tier, so let's add another topic. Okay, if you click the circle, it disappears and then reappears, making it a bit more interactive when you're using it. And so that's, there you go. So you can, again, move things around as you'd like. Let's say we're going to put it over here and then put it back over here. So it can be a bit finicky, but it's a very simple and easy and free tool to use to do digital concept mapping. If you found this video helpful, do click like below and let me know. If you have any questions, you can ask them in the comment box and I'll get back to you as soon as possible. And if you want more advice, there are these videos too with more ed tech tools to check out.